On the 16th February 1977, the atrocities under Amin's reign of terror reached a notch higher when the Archbishop of the Church of Uganda, Janani Luwum, was slain. It is a murder that captured the global imagination, leaving the country teetering on the edge.
When they examined, these are the following things they confirmed. Number one, that the body actually was that of Archbishop Janani Luwum. Number two, that he was completely naked. A hole in his throat ran below his Adam's apple through to the back of his neck. They saw a hole in his left abdomen going through his back. It was a wound, there was a wound inflicted by something like a sword. His back had been broken by cutting it with a sharp instrument.
Today, set in motion incidents that led to the murder of Archbishop Janani Luwum. 40 years since the man of God was murdered by President Idi Amin for his fight against injustice in this country. In the words of Justice James Ogora, Uganda became the world's capital of martyrdom.
The faithful star of Janani Luwum has gone places. Step by step, the barbarity of the execution that he suffered under the blood-soaked hands of a brutal dictator pricked the conscience of the international community.
However, this emboldened and hastened the armed struggle to bring the end to this tyranny where thousands of people were massacred.
Currently, efforts are afoot to reclaim the once notorious Nakasero House of Horrors for rededication as the hallowed house of Luwum's martyrdom.
Today, the Church of Uganda at Namirembe Cathedral flagged off commemorations ahead of the 16th February to mark 40 years since Luwum was killed after he had a dispute with Idi Amin.
If Idi Amin came back today and right now, and he found us worshipping here, and he says, those of you who say Janani Luwum did the right thing, stay in the church and you will be killed. Those of you who say, we are just invited here, you are free to go out. How many would you stay in this church?
The prelate is celebrated for his courage to speak to power, even if it meant sacrificing his life. Janani Luwum's son, Ben Okero Luwum, delivered a message from his mother about the day when he was killed.
Because they immediately collected her and her children from Namirembe and took her to Mukono, where they could hide while arrangements were being made to take them to exile in Kenya.
Prime Minister Dr. Ruhakana Rugunda recalls how he went into exile after the death of Luwum. Others who left the country were former UPC Party President Oraro Otunu, who was by then the great president of Makerere University.
Uganda will benefit from again the Archbishop's legacy of mentoring the young people with values that make society a better society to live in.
40 years since he was killed, Luwum has become a global symbol of selfless and martyrdom to the Christian fraternity.
He is already recognized as saint far and wide, London, in many different centers.
It was absurd. A head of state killing a head of denomination.
During a commemoration anniversary last year, President Yoweri Museveni designated 16 February as a public holiday to honor Luwum. Today, it was revealed at the church house, whose construction along Kampala Road is about to be completed, will be named Janani Luwum House.
Something symbolic about 40 years as a nation as we celebrate this memorial.
Born in 1924 in the backwaters of Muchwini in Kitugumu district, Luwum's name tracked the pantheon of great men as the annals of history hold him aloft. Jingo Francis, NTV.